speaker, but it's not technically a filibuster, right?
Not yet, because to be an actual technical filibuster, you have to be holding up some piece of legislation. He's not technically doing that right now. But if he keeps speaking until midnight, he will technically be doing that on the trade bill. But regardless, he's talking, as you said, and he's going to keep talking, maybe even overnight. It just depends on how long he can go. The reason he's doing this is because he is opposed to continuing or extending the key provisions of the Patriot Act. They're going to expire on June 1st, which have to do with NSA wiretapping, which he has long, long, long opposed. He's also running for president, and it just so happens that the minute he took to the Senate floor, it was a coordinated effort with his presidential campaign to send tweets to raise money and also to keep kind of the momentum going, because, you know, it certainly isn't a unified position on the Republican side to be opposed to this. There are plenty of fellow Republicans who say that we need these rules because they're put in place under George W. Bush. But Rand Paul is very unique in some ways in the Republican field, in that he has tapped into the libertarian kind of anti-big government fervor out there that really very much does exist in the Republican Party. And for him, he is their candidate on the GOP side. So he wants to gin up their support.
Fascinating. Let's turn to the other side of the aisle, another political presidential story. The Wall Street Journal has a report that Hillary Clinton's political aides inside the U.S. State Department while she was Secretary of State, quote, sometimes blocked the release of documents requested under public records law. What can you tell us about that? Is that unusual?
Well, apparently, when it comes to freedom of information requests, which CNN does, you know, news organizations do across the board, it's not unusual to take some time to get responses, because they sometimes do get held up because of the political wings of the agencies looking into it. But ultimately, they should, if they follow the law, give over what journalists and others are requesting. In this particular report, the Wall Street Journal has sources saying that some key things that people were looking for were actually not turned over because political appointees, and actually named Cheryl Mills, who was Hillary Clinton's chief of staff and her longtime advisor, actually held them up. Now, I should say that the Clinton campaign denies that. At the State Department, they say it is not unusual for political figures to be involved in these decisions. But I will say that this obviously would not be an issue if transparency at the State Department weren't already an issue for Hillary Clinton. And one good government group, the Center for Effective Government, actually went through all the agencies and put the State Department dead last in terms of those who respond to FOIA
when she was in charge of it.